So recently, Notion released a bunch of new updates, with the biggest ones by far being the updated Notion formulas and the new automations feature. This video will just quickly cover all of the updates, but if you'd like to see a dedicated video for both the new Notion formulas and automations, then be sure to give this video a like and let me know down in the comments. Now let's jump straight into the first and most important update, the new Notion formulas. The first immediate change that you'll notice is that underneath the formula, there is a preview of what the formula will display and that the formula won't update until you click done. And if you go back into your formula to make changes, there is this revert button that you can click at the top to undo all of your changes. Another big change is the ability to create multi-lines using Shift and Enter. You can also add tabs to your formulas as well as add comments, just like with coding. And when there is an error in your formula, it will now be highlighted with red, making it a lot easier to find and fix. Formulas now also support rich data outputs. Previously, formulas only supported text, numbers and checkboxes, or Boolean values. Now they can also display pages, dates, people and lists. Formulas can now also reach into properties of related databases, just like rollups, and use specific property information in the formula. And when referencing a specific property, you no longer will see the long prop function, but instead just the name of the property with a gray background. And you also don't need to add functions in the beginning of your formula with an open bracket and then a closing bracket at the end. You can now simply just add new functions from left to right by simply adding a dot. This combined with multi-line editing and the simpler property function will make formulas so much easier to understand and use. And for those wondering, all your existing formulas that you had before this update will already be updated to the new formula language, so there's no need to go back into each formula and update them manually. There's obviously a lot more to cover for the new formulas, as there's a bunch of new functions that's been added and old ones that's been removed, but I'll cover everything in the next video, depending on how many likes this video gets. Also, do let me know in the comments if there is any specific formula that you want me to create and showcase in the next video. Moving on to the second update, we have the new Notion automations feature. This new little lightning bolt at the top of your database allows you to create powerful if this, then that statements. This is the first feature Notion has added that's only available on the paid plans, so you'll need to upgrade to use this feature, or you can just use a free third-party automation software like Zapier, Make, or Pipedrive. How this works is fairly simple. You have a trigger and an action. For example, the trigger can be if someone changes the status of a task to complete, and then the action that results from that trigger can be to mark the task as complete, add today's date for the date completed, and tag a specific person to review the task. You could even add or edit database entries in other databases or send a message to a specific Slack channel. There's a lot of different ways you can use this new feature, and I'm planning to create a dedicated video about it if that's something you'd want to see. And for those who've already played around with this new feature, let me know in the comments what are some use cases you found for this new automations feature, and I'll be sure to include them in the next video. Now with the two big ones out of the way, let's get into the smaller updates. Another addition to all the new AI properties is AI Translate, which will automatically translate any text into a predetermined language. And for those not yet familiar with the other three AI properties, you can summarize database entries, extract all the key information, and also custom fill the property with AI-generated text based on a specific prompt. Next up, we have a very minor update, which is the ability to now freeze columns by dragging this vertical bar on the left over the properties that you want to freeze. So if you have a long database with lots of properties and need to constantly scroll left to right, you can now freeze the name property along with other important information so that when you scroll, you can still, for example, see the person's name that the database entry belongs to. The next update is a nice addition to Notion's native icon collection, which is an icon of the Notion logo itself. Notion has now also added the long overdue feature, which is the ability to choose what template you want to apply to your buttons for creating new database entries. When editing your button, you'll now see this extra option at the top to select one of the templates to add onto the new database entry that will be created from the button. A small but very useful feature. Another small but useful update is dynamic references that you can now use inside template buttons. For the date property, you can use today and now, and for the people property, you can use the person duplicating the template button. For coders, you can now click on the three-dot menu on a code block and use the new format code option that will fix your code. And another update that you might have already noticed is that when you hover over a page inside your Notion workspace, it will now display a preview of the content inside that page. If you want to be the first to know of any new Notion updates, get access to more free Notion templates, tips and resources, as well as learn how to use Notion to increase your focus and productivity, then be sure to subscribe to my new Notion newsletter through the first link in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.